So today we're checking out a pair of audiophile earbuds, and I'm really excited to dive into the details to share with you how they sound like, how they perform, and whether or not you should get yourself one. So HIDIZS is a fairly solid brand in the audiophile market and has quite a lot of offerings from DAC AMPS to players to IEMs, so let's see if they're any good. Welcome to a review of the HIDIZS MS2. Hello, my name is Sean and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I do a lot of tech reviews as well as unboxing, and if that is something that interests you, do consider subscribing to this channel. Leave a thumbs up on this video as well as share this video to all your friends around. And with that said, let's get on with a review of the HIDIZS MS2. So today's review unit was sent over to me by HIDIZS, and these earbuds is not the traditional Bluetooth earbuds that we're used to seeing, but we're stepping into audiophile territory a little bit here and to check out a pair of proper audiophile IEMs. So these earbuds retails for a super budget $90, which is around 380 Malaysia ringgit, and in the world of audiophiles, I would say that these are some properly well-priced earbuds that also performs really well. So if you're interested in getting these earbuds, I'll leave some of my links in the description below. So the MS2 is designed as every IEMs in the world should be designed, with a beautiful IEM shape and nice contours everywhere that fits in the ear nice and snugly. The color that I have here is the blue one, and HIDIZS also sells the MS2 in 4 different colors, so you can find something that you really like. The shell here is made of an eco-friendly resin body that gives you quite a lot of comfort for long periods of use, and from my experience, they really do feel quite comfortable. And at the front panel here, you get a phosphorescent panel that has quite a nice shiny surface inside, so everything that you see inside here that shines is the phosphorescent material, and giving the IEM a pretty nice and cool design. So you won't be quite able to see, but there's a HIDIZS logo in the front here, and at the top here you will also see the HIDIZS.com website there. So personally, I think it's not so cool to have a website on the earbuds, but anyway, it's not very visible. So unlike most Bluetooth earbuds, there's no controls on these earbuds, there's no touch sensor, there's no buttons, just pure old school proper earbuds that you can control with your player or your turntable if you're super retro. So as you've noticed earlier, the HIDIZS MS2 has a cable that detaches. So that's a very good thing in the audiophile genre, is that everything should be detachable, and that's the case for the cables of the MS2 as well. So HIDIZS gives you a nice mixed braiding of quad core cables, and what does it mean is that if you look inside the cable very closely, you get 4 wires braided together forming one single cable, and this is a mix of high purity silver wires and oxygen free copper wires. So this is quite a nice combo, because the design and build of the cables ensures that you get a clean signal transmitted from your player to your earbuds with very little interference. So traditionally, some people swear on using silver wired cables because it gives you a nice bright lively sound signature, and some people swear by copper cables because it gives you a good warm tone. So honestly, this is very subtle feeling, and definitely some audiophiles can feel the difference, but I think all in all, it boils down to what type of sound signatures that you like, so that's something that you can consider. So a benefit of a detachable cable is that you can upgrade these cables in the future. Say if you want more high-end cables, you can also make that switch. Plus, if the cables are detachable and you break it in the future, you can also just swap out the cables and you don't have to change the entire earbud. So HIDIZS uses a 0.78 millimeter 2-pin gold-plated socket, so you can swap out to any similar spec cables, or you can also get the Bluetooth transmitter from HIDIZS to convert your earbuds into wireless earbuds. And if you can see, the connector that we have here from HIDIZS is very high quality, it's gold-plated, HIDIZS branding here, and this is a TRS tip, so tip ring sleeve, And the splitter here that they use also comes in a nice rose gold color here. So why this is that you can pull this so that you can manage the wires better. So in terms of its feature, the earbuds comes with pretty great specs, and starting with the drivers, you're going to get a 10.2mm dynamic driver, and HIDIZS uses a quite fancy material they call macromolecular composite diaphragm 2.0, and in my opinion, when you see version numbers in anything, you definitely know it's legit. So apart from that, the earbuds also comes with Knowles 33518 balanced armature drivers to drive clean, crisp details into your noggings, so this is very nice. And these earbuds are also high-res certified, so you know you're getting superb sound quality with these earbuds, and later we'll talk a little bit more about sound signature. But lastly, I just want to point out that these earbuds are rated at 18 ohms, and that is the impedance that these earbuds runs in, and anything below 50 ohms usually is designed to work with your smartphones or MP3 players, and the player should drive enough power into these earbuds, but you can definitely tell the difference between different ohms earbud. So using the MS2 with the Sony NWA-105, you're gonna see quite a powerful sound signature pushed into these earbuds on its own, meaning you're gonna get quite a loud volume at about say 50%. In contrast, if you use the Philips Fidelio X2HR with a rated 30 ohms, the same 50% sounds so much softer because it needs more power to drive those drivers. So you definitely don't need an amp for these earbuds, but if you do have, you can switch up the gain a little bit on your amp, amplify the source a little bit more, and sometimes it does give you better results with your audio. So let's talk a little bit about the audio quality of these earbuds, and I'm gonna switch a bit from my traditional Bluetooth analysis and be a little bit more analytical with these earbuds, since these are kind of audiophile earbuds. So streaming these earbuds with Tidal with any master quality authenticated audio is the way to properly enjoy these earbuds, and if you have any lossless formats like FLAC or Apple Lossless, those will be the best. So the bass on these earbuds are not strong, so they are not your rumbling, crazy, deep type of bass, and don't quite give you that sub-bass feeling. However, the mid bass does sound present, again not crazy deep, but sufficiently present to give you a good dynamic sound signature. Vocals or the general mid-range sound amazing with these earbuds, honestly, giving you a very good vocal range that sound really present and forward. These earbuds are not tuned as your typical V-shaped earbuds in terms of EQ, and hence gives you a very good vocal reproduction. So highs is where these earbuds really shines, with that Knowles BA driver gives you absolute crisp, high definition crisp. The cymbals, the hi-hats all sound exceptionally well defined, not messy, and projects really well. So soundstage on these are not wide and they don't sound airy at all, so which is understandable because these are in-ear earbuds and not open back headphones like the X2HR, which the X2HR gives you a very exceptional soundstage, like you can stretch out your hands to reach those sounds. These don't provide you with that feeling. So overall, I really love these earbuds and the sound signature, and they really sound really high quality and high resolution, which I totally recommend. So high-res audio is really a genre that I love, and I can really just talk about how excited I am with them, and I'm really still learning the ropes of high-end audio. There's really so much more to learn, but a good reference point, the Philips Fidelio X2HR, gives me a really high-quality benchmark for now, and the MS2 is no slouch, keeping up really nicely with those headphones. So I'll also review the DAC-AMPS from HIDIZS soon, so stay tuned for that, and we'll see how we can pair that up with the MS2 as well as the Fidelio X2HR to see how good they make the earbuds or headphones sound. So that is it for this review. If you find this video helpful, smash that thumbs up button, share this video everywhere, and if you haven't yet subscribed, do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.